You must know what do you mean by quadrilateral. So quadrilateral is that figure having four unequal sides, four-sided figure and closed figure. Okay, whose sum of all interior angle is 360 degree. Okay, everyone, and it has two diagonals. By applying the formula also, it has two diagonals, and so whose sum of all interior angle is equal to 360. So this is all about the quadrilateral. Okay, so let us discuss the questions of these exercises. In which you have given a first question.
Question answers. First question fill ups, then all our statement sums, and there are total 10 sums are there. Okay everyone, so we will discuss these sums today. Okay,
so in first sum you have a quadrilateral has dash sides. How many sides are there? 4 sides. Okay, dash vertices means corner. How many corners are there? 4 corners are there. Look at the quadrilateral. This is quadrilateral. 4 corners or 4 vertices, 4 sides and dash angles. How many angles are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 angles, 4 sides, 4 vertices and how many diagonals are there? I have already discussed. There are 2 diagonals. Okay, so this is first fill up. And second one is sum of all interior angle is 360. So second figure is 360 degree. Okay everyone, so you can also do it by doing the activity at home by converting into two triangles and applying. You know the sum of triangle is 180, so 180 plus 180 will be equal to 360. This is also an activity, very good activity. Okay, a third one is a measure of each angle of the convex quadrilateral is dash then 180. So it is in convex quadrilateral. So quadrilateral has two types. Okay, one is a convex quadrilateral in which each of the angle is less than 180 degree. Less than 180 degree. And a quadrilateral having one of the angle is greater than 180, is greater than 180, that is called concave quadrilateral, and this is convex quadrilateral. So there are two types of quadrilaterals, concave and convex. He is talking about the measure of each angle of the convex quadrilateral is less than 180 degree in the convex quadrilateral. Okay, now let us discuss second question in which you have to check whether it is a quadrilateral or not. So angles are given. This is second question, first part 101, 62, third one is 89, and fourth one is 108. We have to check whether it is quadrilateral or not. So do one thing, sum to find the sum. If the sum is equal to 360, then it is a quadrilateral. If the sum is not 360, then it is not a quadrilateral. So 8 plus 17, 19 plus 1, 20, 2, 2, 10, 16, 1, 2, 3. So the total is 360. So that means it is a quadrilateral. These are the angles of a quadrilateral figure. Okay, now similarly you can find the second and third part. If the sum is 360, then it is quadrilateral. If the sum is not a 360, then it is not a quadrilateral. Because it is a quadrilateral, so write it is a quadrilateral. Okay, now in the third question, you have given angle A 100 degree, angle B 60 degree, angle C is 60 degree also. We have to find the fourth angle. So let the fourth angle is equal to x, and we know that angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D, the sum of four angles is equal to 360. So put the values 100 plus 60 plus 60. D will down also put it x and find it 100 plus 60 plus 60 220 plus x is equal to 360. So to find the value of x, make it on this side and 360 minus 220, which is equal to 140 degrees. So it means angle D is equal to 140. So understood how to find the unknown angle if three angles are given in a coordinate. So in the same way, there are other questions. Fourth question is there. In fourth question, you have the angles are in the ratio. Ratio mein given hai. Ratio mein jab given hote hai, so remember one thing. Ratio jab bhi given ho, so usko uske aage x lagao. To find the value of ratio mein given hai. Find the ratio 3, ratio 5, ratio 6. Okay. So jab bhi angles ratio mein ho, so let the angles are 1x, 3x, 5x, and 6x. So we know sum of all angles of quadrilateral is always equal to 360 degree. So sum of all angles 11, 14, and 15. So to find the value of x, we have to divide by 15. So divide by 15 and find the value of x. 15, 2, and 4. So x is 24. So it means angles are, so first angle will be 1x. 1x means 1 into 24. And second angle will be 3x. So 3 into 24, you can find it. Then 5x, 5 into 24, and 6 into 24 is last one. So you can find the answer by multiplying it. So this is all about your fourth question. Okay, fifth question is three angles of the quadrilateral are equal and fourth angle is right angle. So three angles equal hai. Let the angles are x, 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 and fourth one is given the right angle. It means 90 degree. So because three angles are equal, so maine usko x maan liya. And we know that sum of all the angles of the quadrilateral is 360. So x plus x plus x, 3x plus 90 is equal to 360. We have to find the value. 3x would be equal to 270. X would be equal to 270 divided by 3. That is equal to 90. Yes. So it means all angles are 90 degree. So it means angles are 90, 90, 90, and 90. So it means it may be square or rectangle. Okay. So in sixth question, you have given two adjacent angles are 52 degree and 110 degree. Okay, and other two angles are same. Same means we assume it as x and x. So we have to find the other two angles. We know that the sum of four angles of the quadrilateral is equal to 360. So to find the value of x, first add this. So it would be 2, 6, and 1 plus 2x is equal to 360. So 2x would be equal to 365 minus 162 and find the value of x. Okay everyone. So 2x would be equal to 360 minus 162. So 8, 15, 9 and 1. So answer is 198. So x would be equal to 198 divided by 2, which is equal to 99. So it means other two angles are 99. In seventh question, a coordinator having three acute angles, each of measure 85. It means you have given three angles and all are equal to 85, and we have to find the fourth angle. So let the fourth angle is x. So So it means according to your property of coordinator, the sum of all four angles is equal to 360. So add up all the values and find the value of x. So it is the same as your previous questions. Okay, third one. And let us discuss the second part. Now, the four angles of the coordinator are given like this. First angle is 2x into x minus 10. This is first angle, comma. Second one is this one. Third one is given x plus 50. And fourth one is given 2x. So, you know sum of all the angles is equal to 360. So, it is just a calculation part. You have to add up all the four angles and it will be equal to 360, because it is a bracket, so you have to multiply it. It would be equal to 2x, sorry, it is not x, it is multiplied. So 2 into this means 2x minus 20 plus x plus 30 plus x plus 50 plus 2x is equal to 360. And take the x terms together. Okay, 2x plus x, 3x, 4x and 6x. 30 minus 20, 10. 10 plus 50, 60. Okay, make it 60. And find the value of x by subtracting it first. Then your answer is 300. Then x would be equal to 300 divided by 6. That is equal to 50 degree. So here is the fourth angle. Next question, you have to find the angle of QPR. Find angle QPR. It means this angle. Okay. So this sign means 90 degree. This is also 90 degree. And you know it is, look at the figure carefully. QBRB is a coordinator because it is a four-sided figure. So the sum of four angles is equal to 360 coordinator, you know. So it means angle B plus angle R plus angle P plus angle Q is equal to 360, in which angle B is given 35, angle R is 90 degree, again angle P is 90 degree, sorry, P is not given, so make it as angle P and Q is 90 degree. So find the value of P by adding all the values and subtract it from 360. So P plus 180, 180 plus 3, 215. Subtract it from 360, you get the answer. Okay everyone? Next question is a 9th question, in which a diagram is given, and we have also given that AP is a bisector of angle A. Bisector का मतलब होता है कि वो angle को two equal parts में divide करता है. So it means अगर ये angle X है, तो ये भी angle X होगा. और similarly BP is also a bisector. It means अगर this angle is Y, so this angle is also Y. Okay? So now before doing this question, we know it has four sided figure ABCD and the sum of four angles is equal to 360. ये तो प्रॉपर्टी आपको पता ही है. तो एंगल ए प्लस एंगल बी जो कि आपको पता नहीं है, तो इसको ऐसे ढूंढ लो. एंगल सी इज 50 डिग्री, एंगल डी इज 100 डिग्री. तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ एंगल ए प्लस एंगल बी. ये इसका टोटल आ गया 150, तो उधर आ गया 150 माइनस हो गया. तो एंगल ए प्लस एंगल बी वुड बी इक्वल टू माइनस कर दो 210 आ गया. So it means now you can write angle A as 2 times x, क्योंकि angle A को आप x plus x भी लिख सकते हो. Okay, तो x plus x is 2x. Similarly angle B is 2y, which is equal to 210, because हमने angle P find करना है. That's why we are writing like this. Okay, now take the two common. You have x plus y is equal to 210 and x plus y will be equal to 210 divided by 2, which is equal to 105. Okay everyone, so now you have the sum of two angles, that is x plus y is equal to 105, and we have to find the value of P. And so take it as another triangle in which you have given x and y and angle P. So three angles of the triangle is always equal to, very good, it is always equal to 180 degree, angle sum property of the triangle. So x plus y you have given 105, and angle P you have to find. So to find the value of angle P, we will subtract it from 180, and your answer will be 75 degree. Okay everyone? So the last question we will discuss, you can try it yourself. It is same as this ninth question. So you can try it yourself, and if you have got a problem, you can ask me. Thank you everyone.